Last class we finished with Pratyanikam Alankara. Now it is Militam. Samena Lakshmana Vastu Vastuna Yen Niguhyate Nijena Agantuna Vapi Tatu Militam Iti Smritam. So, sahajam Agantukamba Kimapi Sadharanam Yetu Lakshanam Tadvarena यत्किंचित् केनचित् वस्तु वस्तुस्थित्यैव बलीयस्तया तिरोधीयते तद् मीलितम् इति द्विधा स्मरन्ति. There are two types of मीलितम् अलंकार. मीलितम् द वर्ड इटसेल्फ मीन्स समथिंग इज कवर्ड. सो द एक्चुअल इट कुड बी वन ऑब्जेक्ट हैज टू डिफरेंट और सॉरी द एफेक्ट्स ऑफ something, there are two objects which give out the same effects, and one is actually covered by the other. So the examples make it more clear, but how the definition goes is samena lakshmana, either nijena samena lakshmana vastuna vastu niguhyate athava agantuna samena lakshmana vastuna vastu niguhyate. So there are two types here. What it means is sahajam agantukam va kimapi sadharanam. So there is one which is present in the body itself or in the person itself. We are trying to describe, say, a lady here, and that lady is displaying certain characteristics. So the characteristics could actually, the characteristics are actually because of some reason. Say madam, for example, in the first example, it is let's do this combined with the udaharanam. So apanga tarale drisho madhura vakra varna giraha vilasa bharamanthara gatihi ativa kantam mukham iti spuritam angake mrigadrishaha swato lilaya tadatra na madodayaha kritapada api sanlakshyate. Madodayaha mada udayaha, madasya udayaha, intoxication, kritapadaha api, even though it has taken place in her body, yet na samlakshyate, it is not seen because of what? Swataha leelaya mrigadrishaha, because of the beautiful lady's swataha leelaya, by her natural grace, the effect of mada, intoxication, is not clearly seen. So now what it is what are all those that is reflected in her body? Angake spuritam, angake kim kim spuritam, drishav apanga tarale. Drishav, both her eyes are apanga taralam. The corners are very taralam, like trembling or tremulous, which is keeping on moving this way and that way. So drishav evam staha. Madhura vakra varna giraha. Her words are having varnam, which are vakram, this way and that way. So it is not like a speech. So madhura vakram. She's talking, blabbering something, but at the same time, it is very sweet. It is vakra vartaha, vakra shabdaha upayojayati sa. Shabdana upayojayati. So madura vakra varnaha giraha vilasa bharamanthara gatihi. Gatihi tu vilasena vilasasya bharena manthara manda gatihi. Her walk is very languorous. That is, she's taking her own sweet time and walking in a very beautiful manner because of the Shringara Vilasam that is there in her body, which is slowing her down. Ativa kantam cha mukham. Mukham is very attractive, captivating face. Now, all of these are mrigadrishaha angake spuritam swataha leelaya. It is a natural grace that is there in her. As soon as a lady enters into Yavvanam, her eyes, she always starts looking in the corner of her eye. She doesn't look directly. She's no longer, she's out of that innocent stage, right, where everything is straightforward. She's gotten into that Yavvanam here. So, apanga tarale drishav. The same can also apply to mada udayaha. When someone is intoxicated, they also will not look straight. There will be an intoxicated gaze, which is very resemblant of a girl who is in Yavvana. right? Madhura, vakra, varna, intoxication can also give rise to giraha, words which are vakram, which are twisted, but at the same time, which is very sweet if it is in your priya, naika. And her gatihi, either due to intoxication or due to leela, a grace, a shringaram that enters in the body, which makes her walk in a very beautiful and seductive fashion, her face can also be attractive. Now, swataha leelaya, na madodayaha, na samlakshyate. So, madodayaha, kritapadaha api, even though the intoxication has taken place in her body, has taken a foot in her shariram, it is still not perceptible. Na samlakshyate, katham swataha leelaya eva spuritam. Now, what happens here? Let's look at the lakshanam. Sahajam kimapi sadharanam yatu lakshanam. So sahajam, a naturally present in her body, it is not caused by something else. So the naturalness covers something which has been caused in her body by another vastu. Kenachit anya vastuna utpaditam lakshanam chinham. So lakshmana, lakshmana anya vastunaha lakshmana chinnena. Yat vastu niguhyate, the effects of all that madaha in her body is being covered by swataha leelaya. It is being described as it is a natural occurrence in her body. So that sahajam leelaya yat janitam apanga taralatvam athava madhura vakra varnatvam vilasa bara mantaratvam kantatvam, all of these are actually madajanita chinhani. Kintu atra katham varnyate swataha leelaya eva utpaditani iti varnyate. Right? So sahajam kimapi sadharanam yatu lakshanam tadvara, sahaja lakshana dvara, sahaja chinna dvara, yat kinchit kenachit anyena vastuna, yatkinchit vastu baliyastaya tirodhiyate, it is forcibly covered. Even though intoxication is present, it is not seen because her naturally she walks like that. It is not intoxication that is causing this. So that sort of a covering you're doing for something that is, you're trying to cover the reality here. In a beautiful manner. Chamatkaraha asti chedeva tatra alankaratvam bhavet. So, atra drik taralatadikam angasya lingam. Lingam, Lakshma. Lakshma is also Lingam, Chinnam, ityadi. So, Swabhavikam, Sadharanam. Sadharanam, it is common to both Leela and Madaha. Madaudayaha. I think Sadharanam cha, Madaudayena. I made a spelling error there. So, Madaudayena, Tatrapi etasya darshanatu. Madaudaye api. Drik taralatvadikasya darshanat ubayoho sadharanam lingam atra madodayena na kriyate kintu sahaja leelaya eva kriyate iti varnitatvat meelitam alankara. Okay. The next one is not sahajam, but what is the second part? It says agantukena. So, right, agantuna. Agantukam va kimapi. Now you remove the sahajam in the definition and put in agantukam. Agantukam is an external force which is causing this. So this is internal cause. Sahaja leela is internal cause. And then the next one is external cause. Ye kandarasu nivasanti sada himadrehe tvatpata shankita dhiyaha vivasha dvishaste apyangam utpulakam udvahatam sakampam teshamaho bada bhiyam na budhopi abhignyaha. The kavi is addressing the king and he is saying, te dvishaha, your enemies. Now, the king has defeated a lot of these other kings, and the other kings have now gone and taken refuge into the caves of Himalayas. Now, the caves of Himadrehe Kandarasu, normal caves are themselves very cold. But himadrehe kandarasu, so atishitatvam tatra vyajyate, right? It is being indicated here. So हिमाद्रेहे कंदरासु ये निवसंति सदा निवसंति दे आर सो डिजेक्टेड बाय द डिफीट एंड दे आर आल्सो अफ्रेड दैट यू विल कम एंड त्वत् पात शंकित धियः द्विषः दे आर अफ्रेड ऑफ गेटिंग अटैक्ड बाय यू त्वत् पात तव हननात् शंकिताः शंकित धियः ये द्विषः छत्रवः ते सदा सर्वदा हिमाद्रेहे कंदरासु निवसन्ति गुहासु निवसन्ति नो गुहानां शैत्यत्वं वर्तते सो व्हाट हैपेंस नेचुरली देयर बॉडी विल फील शिवरिंग एंड रोमांचमपि भवेत बट हाउ ही इज ट्राइंग टू कवर दैट इज सो अपि अंगम उत्पुलकम उद्वहतां सकंपम तेषामहो भतभ्यां न बुधोपि अभिज्ञः नोबडी कैन फिगर आउट दैट इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ फ्राइट that they are trembling or that their body is romanchita. So those who are actually afraid of you and are in the staying, always staying in the caves of Himadri, Himalayas, they are shivering. Okay? Sakampam, they are shivering. And utpulakam, their bodies have angam utpulakam api, angam utpulakam sakampam, angam udvahatam tesham. So those who are possessing bodies, udvahatam tesham. Bodies, udvahatam, sorry. Those who are possessing a body, angam, which is utpulakam, which is showing that horripilation, romancham, and sakampam, which is also shivering. Tesham shatrunam bhiyam abhignyaha budaha api na asti. Even an intelligent person cannot notice their fright. Bhiyam abhignyaha. Abhignyaha lakshayita. One who is recognizing the fear in them. They cannot recognize it because even an intelligent will think that, see, they are staying in the caves of Himalayas. It is the cold that is making them shiver. And that is why they have goosebumps all over their body. So they are not able to even detect the bhiya, bhihi, bhayam in them. So atra, it is not a natural kampa pulakam that is there in them, but it is the agantuka shaityavashat tesham sharire yat chinham vartate. Kamparupam athava pulakarupam cha chinham yat vartate tat niguhyate. Kena vastuna, sorry, shaityena vastuna niguhyate. It is actually bhihi, bhayajanita chinnam eva. They are actually afraid that this king will attack them anytime, but that fright is not noticeable. It is imperceptible. Right? And people who see it actually think that it is only because of shaityam. So, atratu, samarthyad avasitasya shaityasya. Avasitasya, that which is present there. So, the shaityam which is present, agantukatvat, it is an external cause. Tat prabhavayoho api kampa pulakayoho. The natural bhiti can give rise to kampa and pulaka. Agantuka shaityam also can give rise to kampa and pulaka. Tadrupyam samanata cha bhayeshu api tayoho. So there is a commonality between bhayam and shaityam here. And so that causes this confusion. Not confusion. If it is confusion, it is Bhrantimata Alankara. But here he is very clearly saying the actual cause is not seen. It is only an external cause. Another cause is shown here, and that another cause in the first shloka is sahajam, in the second shloka it is agantukam. Okay, next is a very simple yet beautiful alankara, ekavali alankara. Very cute examples also. Sthapyate, apokhyate, vapi, yathapurvam param param, visheshanataya, yatravastu, sa, ekavali, dvidha. There are two types of ekavali alankara. Purvam purvam prati, yatha uttarasya vastunaha, vipsaya, visheshanabhavena, sthapanam. First one, sthapyate, athava apokhyate, apokhyate, nishedaha kriyate. सो ऐदर पूर्वं पूर्वं प्रति परस्य विशेषणतया स्थाप्यते ऐदर यू एस्टैब्लिश दैट द कंसेक्यूटिव वन्स आर विशेषण फॉर द प्रीवियस वन और यू आर एक्चुअली नेगेटिंग the you are establishing the visheshanatvam by negation but by not establishing not saying directly so there are two ways one is a positive way of looking at it the other one is negative outlook kramena udaharanam first one is sthapanam the next one is dishedhaha purani yasyam sa varanganani varangana roopa puraskritangyah रूपं समुन्मीलित सद्विलासं अस्त्रं विलासः कुसुमायुधस्य यस्यां पुराणि स वर यस्यां प्रोबब्लि नगर्यां ऐ थिंक इट शुड बी यस्यां नगर्यां पुराणि स वरांगनानि लेट मी जस्ट चेक द व्याख्यानम व्हाट ही सेज पद्मगुप्त प्रणीते सी पद्मगुप्त प्रणीते नवसाहसांक चरिते प्रथमे सर्गे राज्ञः विक्रमादित्यस्य नगर्याः उज्जयिन्याः वर्णनम् इदम् सो यस्याम इति उज्जयिन्याख्यां नगर्यां पुराणि गृहाणि ऐ गॉट कन्फ्यूज्ड विद द वर्ड पुरम सो पुरम आल्सो मीन्स सिटी here so yasyam is usually nagari only so here yasyam nagaryam ujjaini nagaryam ujjainyam purani puram iti griham so agare nagare puram ityamaraha amarakosha states that you can use puram for both nagaram and agaram griham okay so pura yasyam in the ujjaini nagaram purani the houses are savaranganani they have very beautiful ladies in the house so the city has in that city there are houses which have beautiful which have women that's all or uttama striyah santi varanganah roopa puraskrita angyah and those women have roopa Rupa is beauty. So they're angi. They have bodies which are puraskritam, which are endowed with rupam beauty. Rupam cha, and that beauty is present with samunmilita sadvilasam. It has a vilasam or a grace. That grace becomes the weapon of kusumayudha. So kusumayudhasya vilasaha eva kusumayudhasya astram bhavati. So each one in the first you find that the puram griham varangana becomes the visheshanam for griham. The rupam is the visheshanam for varangana and vilasaha rupasya visheshanataya sthapyate vilasascha सॉरी अस्त्रं विलासस्य विशेषणतया स्थाप्यते अस्त्ररूपं विलासः इति राइट सो पूर्वं पूर्वं प्रति विशेषणतया परंपरं उत्तरस्य वस्तुनः सॉरी उत्तरस्य विशेषणतया स्थाप्यते उत्तरवस्तु विशेषणतया स्थाप्यते एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज निषेधरूपं न तज्जलं यन्न सुच आई थिंक दिस इज द दंडिन श्लोक न तज्जलं भट्टि काव्ये द्वितीय सर्गे शरत्काल वर्णनमिदम् आई रिमेम्बर यस वेरी वेरी द सेम एग्जांपल अभय दीक्षित आल्सो गिव्स इन हिज कुवल्यानंदम् न तज्जलम् यन्न सुचारु पंकजम् न पंकजम् यत् तत् यद् आलीन षट्पदम् न षट्पदो असौ कलगुञ्जितो न यो न गुञ्जितम् तन्न जहार यन्मनः So, na gunjitam tanna jahara yanmanaha. It is not water, na tatu jalam. Yadu na sucharu pankajam. That which does not have any lotus, if it does not have any lotus, beautiful lotuses, it is not a water at all. It is not to be considered as a water. So, beautiful lotuses become the adjective for jalam. But he is using it in a contradictory manner, saying that if there is no water, then that is not to be considered as a jalam. So a jalam is beautiful only with the visheshanam of pankajam. Now the pankajam also, na tat pankajam yat alina shatpadam. If it does not have a hidden B, it is not a pankajam. So again, what he is trying to say is, pankajam sa leena shatpadameva shobhate natu anyatha. So the lotus needs that black bee in it. Na shatpadoso kalagunjito nayo. That which does not sweetly hums. So kala gunjitaha gunjanam yata na karoti yaha na karoti saha shatpadaha eva nasti. So the shatpadam, the bee is beautiful because of the visheshanam of humming, beautiful humming, sweet humming. Na gunjitam tat, and that too is not a gunjitam if it does not attract or captivate the mind. Yat manaha na jahara. So manaharana, amana akarshana shaktihi yogyata yatra vartate saeva tateva gunjitam asti. Right? Purvatra Puranam Varanganaha Tasam Anga Visheshana Mukena Rupam Tasya Vilasaha Teshamapi Astram Iti Amunakramena Visheshanam Vidhiyate So Stapyate. Uttaratra in the second shloka we have Pratishede Api Evam Yojyam. If it is used in Nishedha Rupam, then it is the second type of Ekavali. Natajalam. I think there is more beauty in this Nisheda Rupa than the Sthapanam. Purani Asyam sa Varanganani Varanganam. More than that, this Natajalam is more beautiful. Okay. Next is Smaranam. Yatha Anubhavam Arthasya Drishte Tat Sadrishe Smritihi Smaranam. And the next part will be for Bhrantimat, the Bhrantiman Anya Samvit Tattulya Darshani. It ends, the Karika ends with that. So just the first little bit is for Smarana Alankara. Yatha Anubhavam Arthasya Tat Sadrishe Drishte Tad Arthasya Yatha Anubhavam Tat Arthasya Smritihi. You have personally experienced something before. Only when you have a first-hand experience about something, you can remember it at a later point. Tasya smritihi bhavishyati. Anubhuta vastunaha eva paschat smritihi bhavati. So it is more than remembering the same object. If you are just remembering the same object, there is no charm in it. When you are experiencing something and you are reminded of something which is similar to this, so it is actually an upama based alankara, but you are expressing it in the form of smaranam. Yatha anubhavam arthasya drishte, so tat sadrishe drishte sati, arthasya sadrishe drishte sati. Yatha anubhavam arthasya smritihi bhavati. So yav padarthaha kenachid akarena niyataha. In some form you understand an object. Yada kadachit anubhutaha bhavati. You are experiencing that object at some point, whenever it may be. Then saha kalantare, at another time, smriti pratibodha adhayini. Tat samane vastuni drishte. At a different point of time, you are looking at an object, vastu, tat samanam, which is equal to that, and which can, which becomes an instigator for that smriti pratibodha. Smriti pratibodha adhayini tat samane vastuni. This object becomes responsible for giving that smritehe udbodham karoti. Sati tat yat tathaiva smaryate tad bhavet smaranam. And you remember the same object in the same manner that you had experienced it before, then it is called smaranam. Two examples he gives. The Vyakhyata gives a beautiful explanation for both examples. He says either asmin janmani athava janmantare. So you can either remember your something that happened in this janma, that is the first one. The something that happened in another janma is for the second one. So the first one is nimnanabhi kuhareshu yad ambav plavitam chaladrisham laharibihi tadbhavaihi kuharutaihi suranaryaha smaritaha surata kantha rutanam. This is a description of Jalakrida by Apsarastriyaha. Smritihi dvivida tatra adhyamuda apsarasam jalakrida varnanam idam. So chaladrisham, one who has very beautiful eyes, tesham nimna nabhi kuhareshu yad ambaha plavitam laharibihi by the river, by the ripples of the river, by the waves, nimna nabhi kuhareshu tesham nimna nabhi kuhareshu tasam chaladrisham, in the when the ripples of water plavitam flowed into the nabhi kuharam of the girls, the deep navels of the girls, with those chaladrisha, with those eyes, they were suranaryaha, celestial ladies, those apsaras trees, they got reminded of the time they were making a sound. See, this sound is called kuharutam. When the water flows into their nabhi pradesham, it makes a little bit of a sound, and that sound is very, they are reminded of the sounds that come during the time they join with their lovers. So, surata kantharutanam, the cooing sound that they do during the suratam. So, sura naryaha smaritaha, the sura yuvati got reminded by the cooing sound that was produced when the water came into their navels. So tadbhavaihi nimna nabhi kuhara bhavaihi kuha rutaihi kuha dvanibihi tesham surata dvanim dvanihi smarane agata. So surata kantha rutanam smaritaha, they were reminded of the sounds during the suratam. So this is in their own janma only. Etat janmani eva apsarasam tu, we don't know whether they have two, three janmas or what. It might happen every pralayam probably. So etat janmani eva anubhutasya smaranam. So kuhadvanihi suradadvanim smarayati. The second one is janmantare. Karayuga grihita yashoda stana mukha niveshita viniveshita adharaputasya samsmrita panchajanyasya namata krishnasya romanchanam. Krishnasya romanchanam namata. You all should do namaskarams to that Krishna's romanchanam. The goosebumps that he gets when he is reminded of panchajanyam. Krishna, namaskarams to that Krishna who remembers the panchajanyam when he held kara yuga in his two hands. Grihitam, he held Yashoda's stanam. Yashoda's stanam, stanamukham, the corner, viniveshita adharaputasya, when he had kept it in his mouth for payapanam, he got reminded of panchajanyam, and he got romanchanam. So that viratvam that he had experienced in another janma, that gave rise to a romanchanam in his body. So panchajanyam is in this janma, means it is going to be in the future. How is Krishna reminded of the future when he is a baby and doing stanyapanam there? Then it is another kalpam only, we'll have to take it. So this one is a very beautiful shloka from Krishna Karnamritam, written by Lila Shukar. Ramo nama babuva. So he is trying to sleep. Krishna is trying to sleep. And janani katham, janani katham hunkarataha shunvataha krishnasya katha esha. So krishnasya varnanam. See, he is sleeping on the, he is trying to sleep. So Yashoda is saying shlokas, a story for him. So this is Rama happened in Krita Yugam. It was the before avataram. So she is saying the story. Ramo nama babuva. there was a king named Rama, whom he is also repeating by saying, you know, we say Oonkotti kada chalrathu, Oonkottrathu. How do we know whether the child is listening to it or not? Ramo Nama Babu. You listen to it, right? By saying whom. So he adds that in the shloka also. Ramo Nama Babu. Tadavala Siteti. His wife was Sita. Piturvacha Panchavati Tate Viharataha. As he was roaming around in Panchavati because of listening to his father's words, Tam Aharatu Ravanaha. Ravana took him. Nidrartham janani katham iti harehe hunkarataha shrunvataha. So Hari, Krishna is listening to this katha that janani is saying for him to sleep. Shrunvataha, as he was listening to it, saumitre kva dhanuriti vyagra girav patunaha. He suddenly gets that avesham when he says, hey saumitre, where is my bow? His rasana vandu romba, it's just too good.
Where is this from, Akka?
Krishna Karnamritam.
This is part of Krishna Karnamritam.
Yes, it is part of Krishna Karnamritam. Ko dhana 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 riti vyagra girav patuna. Okay, so that is also a smarana alankara only. Next one is Brantimad Alankaram. Brantiman Anya Samvidu Tattulya Darshani. Anya Samvidu, you are trying to, you have a confusion here, basically, because two things are Tulyam and you are confused whether this is that or not. Okay, Shukagraha Utkantyat. There is one example in Mookamanjashati also for Brantimad Alankara. I forget that. Maybe I should remember that later. Next time I'll try to get that. So tat iti anyat aprakaranikam. So tat tulya darshane aprakaranikasya tulyasya vastunaha darshane. When you look at, say, bimba phalam, you are reminded of the naika sadharam. So you're looking at something and you are reminded of something else. If you are looking at, say, snow-clad mountains, which is in my backyard, and you are reminded of Kailasa, that is Brantimad Alankaram. Oh, maybe this is Kailasam. So it's like how you are reminded of that. And it should be described in a manner where that Branti is described. You can't just say, I am reminded of that. If you say, I am reminded of that, then it is Smarana Alankara. If you say, I am confused whether this is Kailasham or something else, then that is Brantiman. It is all in the expression. There is a minute difference in the expression. So, Tattulya Darshane, Tatu iti anyat aprakaranikam nirdishyate. Tena aprakaranikena. Tena samanam aprakaranikena samanam arthat iha prakaranikam ashriyate. So tena samanam aprakaranikena samanam prakaranikam, the something, the context which is equal to the non context ashriyate. Tasya tatavidasya drishtau satyam. Tasya tatavidasya ityukte aprakaranikasya drishtau satyam. So aprakaranikasya, when the non-contextual object is in front of our eyes, drishtau satyam, aprakaranikataya samvedanam saha brantiman. And you do know that there is a difference between the two. At the same time, you are confused. This is not Rupaka Alankara, nor it is the Prathama Atishayoktihi, because Vastutaha Brahmasya Abhavat. There is no Brahma in Rupakam and Atishayokti. There is a confusion here. Ihacha Arthanugamena Samyayaha Pravrtehe Tasya Spashtameva Pratipannatvat. Here that Brahmam is clearly seen, and it is like, you're looking at Shukti, you're looking at an oyster and you think it is Rajatam and you go to grab it. So Rajatam iti kritva yadi abhimukam gacchamaha, tat Shuktim prati gacchamaha, tarhi tatra brahmaha vartate. taking that brahma you have an alankara here. Udaharanam kapale marjaraha paya iti karana ledhi shashinaha taruchidra protana visamiti kari sankalayati ratante talpasthana harati vanitapi amshukamiti prabhamattas chandraha jagaditam aho viplavayati. Eshaha chandraha prabhamattaha. His prakasham is very intoxicating here. That prabhamattaha, prabhaya mattaha, adava mattam matta prabha yasya saha, prabha matta yasya saha. So one who has very intoxicating prakasham, the moment you look at the chandra, you forget yourself. Only people like Periva, when they look at Mahapariva, looks at Purna Chandra, he recites Saundar Lahari for the entire night, it seems. Prabhamattaha Chandraha. Idam Jagat Viplavayati Mohayati. This Chandra just deludes the entire world. Katham Marjaraha, a cat. Kapale in its patram. You know, someone puts milk inside the patram. But it looks at the patram and the Shashinaha Karana, the rays of the moon falls into that patram and he thinks it is payaha iti ledhi. He licks that vessel thinking that it is payaha, milk. Kari taruchidra protana Shashinaha Karana bisam iti sankalayati. A kari, an elephant, it thinks that the moon's rays which fall inside the holes that are there in a tree, it lights up there and it thinks that it is bisam, it is lotus stalk, and it starts collecting it, sankalayati. When an elephant thinks that it is the moon's reflection in the tree nodes is bisam. The woman, after ratante, at the end of Rati, she is lying on her bed. So Vanita api talpasthana karana, those moon rays which fall on the bed, she thinks it is amshukam, she thinks it is her vastram, and then grabs it. Harati prabhamattaha chandraha jagaditam aho viplavayati viplavayati sammohayati. Right. Next is pratipam alankaraha. Akshepaha upamanasya pratipam upameyata. We'll stop with this if you're okay. I'll take this next class.
Yeah, okay, Akka.